Hey guys, welcome back to electronicsinnovation.com. If you are using MQTT protocol in any of your IoT projects to communicate with IoT Cloud, then you might be aware of following errors. Attempting MQTT connection failed. RC equals to minus 1 or RC equals to minus 2 or RC equals to minus 4, where RC means return code. These are the general errors you will get while trying to communicate with any MQTT server. My channel comment box and email flooding with these type of errors to seek help to solve these errors every day. I have been answering these emails for a long, but the people are increasing and it is very difficult for me to reply everybody. Therefore, I have decided to make a video to explain these error codes and show you how to solve these errors. So, without wasting much time, let's dive into the episode. This video brought to you by PCBWay.com. We all know that MQTT protocol is the best to connect IoT devices with IoT Cloud. The same way, PCBWay.com is the best way to convert your prototypes into the real-time projects. PCBWay.com offers industry-best PCB manufacturing and assembling services. If you wanted to convert your prototype projects into the real-time applications and deploy in the real-time field, I have provided the link in the description. Do check out their website for more details. Before jumping into the MQTT error codes and solving procedure, let's understand the MQTT protocol first. I will try to explain MQTT protocol briefly. MQTT was invented by Dr. Andy Stanford Clark of IBM and Erlen Nepper of Arcom in 1999. MQTT stands for Message Queue Telemetry Transport. MQTT is standard of IoT messaging. MQTT is an OSI standard message protocol for the Internet of Things or IoT devices. It is designed as an extremely lightweight publish-subscribe messaging transport that is ideal for connecting remote devices with a small footprint and minimal network bandwidth. Today, MQTT is used in a wide variety of industries such as automotive, logistics, manufacturing, smart home, consumer products, and transportation. MQTT architecture. MQTT follows PubSub architecture. Publisher MQTT client will publish data to the MQTT broker. On the other hand, the subscriber MQTT client will subscribe to the MQTT broker to receive the particular data. Based on the subscription status, the MQTT broker will decide which subscriber should receive the published data from the publisher MQTT client. Coming to the error codes, these are generated when we attempt to connect to the MQTT broker. A broker will return a code that tells the client whether the connection attempt was successful or not. These are called as error or return codes. Before going deep about error or return codes, let's see how this MQTT connection works. The MQTT connection is always between one client and the broker. The client never connects directly to the broker without initiating a connection. To initiate a connection, the client sends a connect message to the broker. A good-natured MQTT client sends a connect message with the following content. Once the connection is established, the broker keeps it open until the client sends a disconnect command or the connection breaks. If the connect message is malformed or too much time passes between the opening a network socket and sending the connect message, the broker closes the connection. This behavior deters malicious clients that can slow the broker down. When a broker receives a connect message, it is obligated to respond with connect message. The connect message contains two data entries. One is session present flag and a connect return code. The session present flag tells the client whether the broker already has a persistent session available from the previous interactions with the client. A return code that tells the client whether the connection attempt was successful or not. This is the code we are talking about. Currently, there are 6 return codes available. Code values, return code responses, and their descriptions are as follows. Generally, there are 3 scenarios which causes these errors. One is network connectivity, second is credentials, and third is subscription. Coming to the network connectivity, if there is no internet connection enabled on the connected network or no internet connection on the Wi-Fi or cellular signal causes the errors. Also, if there is an outage in the area at local SIM card operator, you will encounter the same error. Credentials. In my AWS video, we will use certificates as credentials to communicate with AWS IoT broker. If there is any problem with those certificates, you get this error. General mistakes: you forgot to upload certificates to the SPIPS memory of ESP chips, or you forgot to change the name of the certificates in the Arduino code. Try to find any leads regarding these two issues. Most of the problems are from here only. Subscription. You may forget to subscribe to the topic on the MQTT broker, in our case AWS IoT Core. Sometimes I face these issues. For the past 4 years, I have been working with this MQTT protocol to connect my IoT devices to the IoT Cloud. Most probably, these 3 were the issues I have encountered. Check if your current problem matched with any of the above 3 general mistakes. Try to solve them accordingly. If you still face any other issues, please draft a mail to askus.electronicsinnovation@gmail.com. We are always ready to help you and we will try to respond as soon as possible. That's all about MQTT error codes. Stay tuned to Electronics Innovation for more interesting episodes. See you on the next interesting episode. Bye-bye.